Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the introduction to the load forecasting. So load forecasting is very similar to the weather forecasting. In case of weather forecasting, the experts tell us what will be the weather condition in the upcoming future. Similarly, by doing the proper load forecasting, the load conditions in the future can be estimated and the power system planning can be done. So let us study the introduction to the load forecasting. Now we know that as the preference for the electrical energy goes on increasing day by day, more load is induced on the power system. Also, due to increasing population, the load on the power system has increased tremendously. But the resources which are used for the generation of electricity are going on depleting. So the approach has moved on towards the use of renewable sources of energy. Now we all know that the efficiency with the use of renewable sources of energy is very low. Also, there is very much scope for the advancement in the use of the renewable energy sources. But the traditional sources of energy which are used, for example, thermal power plant that uses the coal, this type of power plants require large amount of raw material which is in the form of coal. But the world's coal resources are also going on decreasing. But the load on the power system goes on increasing. For this purpose, the proper forecasting of the load and accordingly the planning is very necessary. Now let us study the introduction. Now due to the preference for the electrical energy throughout the world, the electrification is the very rapid ongoing process. Now during the economic development, demand for the electricity tends to grow more rapidly as compared to the actual generation. So if we see the current scenario, if we compare the generation with the load, the increasing amount of load is very high as compared to the increasing amount of generation. So the generation of this time is not sufficient to provide the total load requirement by the consumer. So the increasing demand on the power system is due to the several factors which are listed below. First is population growth. We all know that world's population is going on increasing. As the population goes on increasing, the people are using more and more electrical appliances. As the usage of electrical appliances increases, the load on the power system also increases. Next is growth per capita income. Then mitigation to the urban areas. Also, increase in the use of energy products. Now the main reason to start the power system planning is, it starts with forecast of the anticipated future loads requirement on both demand as well as energy. So basically load forecasting can be stated as forecasting or anticipation of the future demand on the load, on the energy as well as on the demand on the power system. So by using the forecasting techniques, we can estimate what can be the future demand on the power system and accordingly the provisions can be made for increasing the generation. Now the demand forecasts are used to determine the capacity of the generation, transmission and distribution system, and the energy forecast is used to determine the type of generation facilities that will be required. So depending upon the forecasting, the generation, transmission and distribution can be estimated for the future requirement. Also, we can estimate the demand for the energy. So the load forecast can be useful in establishing the policy of procurement of the capital equipment as well as fuel. Now the generation of energy is a very costly process. So in order to create more generation, the capital requirement is also more. Also, to create more generation, certain equipments are also required. So by doing the proper forecasting, the demand on the power system can be estimated, and as a result, whatever is the requirement of the capital as well as the requirement of the equipments can be forecasted. Now the forecasts are more than simple. Extrapolation of the past data into the future by using the mathematical formula or gathering the trends from the experts. So forecasting can be done by using the past data. Now the power system has the data of the load from the various years. Now using that data, the trend can be realized of the growth in the load on the power system. So using the past data, it can be estimated what is the trend of growth on the demand on the power system. So by estimating this trend, the future requirements can also be estimated. Now forecast are the mechanisms of arriving at the measures of planning the future. So by doing the proper forecasting, the future demand on the power system can be determined, and according to this demand, the planning can be done. So when the forecasting is done properly, they provide an audit trail and a measure of their accuracy. Now the forecasting also helps in planning as well as saving in the cost. Now let us study what is the necessity of load forecasting. So the power system expansion planning starts with the forecast of the anticipated future load requirement. So suppose there is one power station or the power generation plant. Now let us assume that its generating capacity is 500 megawatt. Now as the demand on the power system goes on increasing, there is a requirement to generate more and more energy. So by doing the proper planning or by doing the proper forecasting, we can determine what will be the future demand on the power system. So if the future demand on the power system is known, accordingly the expansion of the generating station can be done. Now the estimates of both demand and energy requirements are crucial in the effective system planning. So if we know what will be the demand as well as what will be the requirement of the load in the future, it will help in proper estimation and planning. Now the demand forecast are used to determine the following parameters. First is capacity of the generation. So if we know what will be the future demand on the generating station, the capacity of the generating station can be determined. Next is capacity of transmission. So the capacity of transmission will again depend upon the future demand. Similar is the capacity of distribution. Then system addition. Similarly, every forecasting determines the type of facilities that are required. Now let us consider one example. If the demand forecast stated that 100 megawatt of capacity was needed and the corresponding annual forecast stated that the need is only of the 2 lakh megawatt hours. In all probability, a peak in generating unit is to be installed instead of the base load unit. Now we know that there are two types of load units, base load unit and the peak load unit. So basically the load for the base load unit is stable, whereas the peak load is the highest magnitude of the load. So the difference in the cost of the two is very substantial. Now the load forecasts are used to establish the procurement policies for the construction capital. So whenever the load forecasting is done, then we can determine what should be the required generation capacity of the future. Accordingly, the expansion of the power system should be done. So for this, the proper procurement of the capital is also necessary. Now for the sound operation, a balance must be maintained in the used debt and equity capital. Further energy forecasts are required to determine the future fuel requirement. Now the maximum energy that is generated today is generated from the fuels. So if the proper forecasting is done, then the future requirement of the fuel can also be estimated. Also, when the fuel prices will soar high, the rate relief to maintain an adequate rate of return can also be predicted by the load forecasting. So in future, there might be the possibility that the prices of the fuel may rise high. As we know that the demand on the fuel is increasing, whereas the sources of the fuel goes on decreasing. So it might happen that the prices of fuel may go high. So it is also necessary that the procurement of the profit is getting from the power system. So for this purpose, the proper load forecasting is needed. So the accurate models for the electric power load forecasting are essential for the operation and planning of an utility company. Now the load forecasting helps an electric utility to make the important decisions, such as first is purchasing and generation of the electric power. So this decision is very important. If the utility requires to purchase the electric power or generate the extra electric power. Next is load switching. Third, infrastructure development. Now the load forecasts are extremely important for the energy suppliers, then ISOs, financial institutions and other participants in the electrical energy generation, transmission, distribution and markets. Now the electrical energy generation is a very large unit. It consists of number of other utilities. So in order to have the proper functioning of each and every utility, proper load forecasting is necessary. Now load forecast can be divided into three categories. First is short term forecast, which is for around 1 hour to 1 week. Next is medium forecast, which has the duration from 1 week to 1 year. And third is long term forecast, which is having the duration of more than 1 year. So depending upon the available data, the forecasting can be done. Now the forecast for the different time horizons are also important for the different operations within the utility company. So in this way, we have studied the introduction to the load forecasting. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.